Dan Gray, weekdays at 5 and 11 on KOVR-TV. The recognized symbol of excellence in sports entertainment.
Challenge. I'm Gorilla Monsoon along with Ring Around the Collar.
Is that my name?
Oh, I'm sorry, Bobby the Brain Heenan. We got plenty of action and excitement lined up for you here this week, so settle back in your easy chair because here we come. Got a hot one here this week on Wrestling Challenge. Talent galore. Coco, beware in singles competition. And you can bet that Frankie won't be far behind. Then 500 pounds plus of the one-man gang.
And the Slickster.
You bet. Demolition, now under the tutelage of Mr. Fuji, has become an extremely dangerous team.
And there's that convict, Ken Patera. The man shouldn't be in wrestling. He shouldn't be in this building. He shouldn't even be in the United States. The man ought to be incarcerated.
Former Olympian Ken Patera joining us as well, and we're going to continue the Billy Graham story. In fact, we're going to have special footage of the operation of superstar Billy Graham, and it is very explicit.
This bout is scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring, weighing in at 232 pounds, from San Antonio, Texas, Dusty Wolf. The opponent, soon to be entering the ring area, from Union City, Tennessee, weighing 229 pounds, the Birdman, Coco B. Ware.
They're on their feet here this week to welcome Coco B. Ware and Frankie, and look at him do his thing.
Let me ask you something. Who dresses this guy? Walt Disney?
Are you kidding with the stuff that you wear? Give me a
stuff that I wear. This guy's dressed like a quarter.
Excitement personified. Coco B. Ware and Frankie really doing a number here in the World Wrestling Federation. How would you like to have a pet like that instead of that horrible weasel that you hang around with?
What would I do with a pet like Coco B. Ware? Oh, you mean the bird?
Yeah, I'm talking about...
I don't want either of them.
Yes, they all love him. Look at Frankie keeping one eye on you, Brain, all the time.
Bird's got a nose like Bruno.
You referring to San Martino?
Not referring to anybody else.
Well, I have to be sure and relay that message for you.
Well, he knows he has a big nose. Just look at his doll.
Uh-huh. Beautiful shot right over the beak, so to speak.
Hey, Bruno!
Certainly a rough road to hoe here for Dusty Wolf, as Coco's obviously on fire this week.
Put that fire out, that's what I'd do.
How are you coming with your therapy for your neck?
Slow. I am making progress, though.
You are.
I can remove it now and then. But,
why don't you remove it once in a while and wash it? You got ring around the collar.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
That's the color of it.
Please. Side headlock by Coco. Wolf doesn't want to stay in this one too long. Drop down over the top. Whoa! Almost landed on Frankie. Right over the top of the back. Reverse sunset coming up. No. Look at that. Waiting for him. Single. Drop kick of beauty. Right in the kisser. Beal out of the corner, nailed him over. I'm glad we're going to be taking a look at the former Olympian this week, Ken Patera.
Sure, he's going to be on here, isn't he?
Yes.
That's right. I want some protection around me. You don't know what that man will do.
Snapmare out of the corner by Wolf. Oh, planted a headbutt right in the sternum. Did your injury have anything to do with the transverse process of the vertebrae? Is that where it was?
I didn't transfer any place. I went to the same doctor.
I'm a talk. Forget about it.
I'm trying to watch this match. You know, Coco throws a lot of people off with his style because he's half wrestling and half dancing. What's wrong with that? It's a wrestling ring. It's not a dancing stage.
Man wants to show his wares, and he certainly does a beautiful job of it. Right now, on the receiving end, Dusty Wolf unloading.
You know what the B's for in his name? I figured that out.
What is it?
Buffoon,
please. Sunset flip. I don't think he'll get it. Didn't have the leverage. Oh, he dropped on him. That'll straighten his turnabout for you. Look out. Coco going to the top. Very high-risk move here. He's going to fly. Drop. Oh. Look at beauty. He nailed him with it.
Now, he don't have to do this.
Do what?
Well, I can't watch this.
Look at this. Oh, I'd like to see one of those planted on him right about now. Ghostbuster indeed and on the victory, Coco.
I don't want to see no replay.
The Birdman, Coco Beware.
Coco Beware really electrifying this crowd here this week. It was a beauty indeed, and there's Frankie doing his thing as well. Look at him. Get down.
Turn that music off.
I love it. Why don't you don't say that when the Honky Tonk Man is out there?
Because that's good music.
Believe. Frankie's going to give us a little dance right now. Look at this.
Look, he's trying to jumpstart the bird.
Give me a break. They're all with it here this week and 100% behind Coco Beware.
Look, look, soon.
Let's
there's
go back.
Consuelo.
Take a look. There it comes. Look at this drop kick, Frank.
Oh.
Right in the kisser.
Really, oh, no, I can't look at this.
Uh-oh. Right now, folks, let's go to Greg DeGeorge for our special rebuttal with Jake the Snake Roberts.
All right, Jake the Snake Roberts, I know you are well aware that the big day is coming next week. President of the World Wrestling Federation, Mr. Jack Tunney, will make that major announcement on whether the DDT will be banned or not.
The first thing is, it should have never happened. This question should have never came up. But what gets me is a man sitting up in a chair listening to somebody else squawking and complaining about something that gets the job done. That's what the DDT does for me. It makes me a little bit better than everybody else. Intimidation has always been the key to my success. That's why Damien is there, and that's why the DDT has always worked. So I tell you what, you go ahead and vote, man. Do what you want to do. But the DDT, as far as I'm concerned, is like life. It's cruel, but it's very fair.
Germany? I'm getting married at 5.
Don't worry. I'll be there.
You go all out. Old Spice deodorant introduces all-out protection. Always coming through. When friends are counting on you, you go all out. You go Old Spice. New white Old Spice Fast Track is clinically proven to block odor better than the leading men's deodorant. That's all-out protection. You go all out. You go Old Spice. All-out protection.
They don't hang around in ladies' clubs or in a three-piece suit. They're too big to call them dainty, too big to call them cute. Yeah, they're so big on chocolate. Ooh, chocolate out to here. It's hard to keep them on the rack.
Hello,
those three musketeers.
So, gentlemen, what's on the agenda for this evening?
Oh, I am on the time of my life.
Can that be done for under $7?
Three musketeers.
Returning a movie.
It don't come easy.
Most people want to do it in the morning. Unfortunately, most video stores are closed, except for 7-Eleven. We have all the top titles at great prices, 24 hours a day. So at 7-Eleven, if you're in a rush, you'll never be left on the outside looking in.
Get the good things easy.
Now you can rent all the latest titles for just 99 cents every day.
I'm 49er Keith Bonhorst. If you're a big guy like me, come into Mr. Big and Tall now for big savings. You'll get a fit that's great and save money too.
Soon, Mr. Big and Tall will move its Country Club Center store to a bigger, more convenient location to become California's biggest Big and Tall. So for a limited time, all three Mr. Big and Tall stores celebrate with a moving sale. Unheard of price reductions on everything in stock. But hurry to Country Club Center, Downtown and Southgate Center for first come, first serve savings during the moving sale at Mr. Big and Tall.
This next bout is scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring from Milford, Connecticut, weighing 230 pounds, Mario Mancini. The opponent, soon to be making his way to the ring area, accompanied by his manager, the Doctor of Style, Slick. From Chicago, Illinois, weighing 450 pounds, the one-man gang.
Look at the size of him, Monsoon.
Certainly looks a lot more than 450 pounds to me. Where did they go? Hang on a meat scale somewhere?
You know, I'm talking to him. He's from Chicago. He's from the south side called Halsted Street, which is the baddest part of town, boy.
One-man gang indeed. Take a look at that mohawk here. What's that? Some kind of a tattoo he's got on the side of his head there?
He's got a tattoo on each side of his head. Skull and crossbones.
Mario Mancini in deep trouble here this week. Awesome power when you put that, as they say, 450 pounds on a 6'7" or 6'8" frame. It's just unbelievable. Very excited about his latest find here in the World Wrestling Federation. Let's go to the Slickster.
Oh yeah, baby, that's it, that's right. Now you see why I'm so ecstatic, because here he is, the big 747, 450 pounds, the one-man gang, yeah.
Well, Slick, as long as you got the cash coming, I'll be out there crippling people and hurting my people out there. You know where I'm going, to the top!
What is that, the crash, cash for crash, or what?
You know what I like about him? He looks like he's a little bit, just a little bit off.
I mean, he's not playing with a full deck.
I don't think he even knows how to deal. I like it.
Got those fingers wrapped up as well. For what purpose, we don't know. Maybe we'll find out.
I wouldn't bother him. I wouldn't ask him.
I'll ask him.
What's he doing now?
Uh-oh, look at this. The big 450-pounder climbing up. He's on the second rope on the inside. Second turnbuckle. Oh, drove Mancini down into the canvas face first. Obviously very pleased with himself as
well. Mancini right now looks like a pavement patty.
Come on, Raph. You going to let him go up there and do that again or
what? Sure.
Mancini obviously half unconscious. One-man gang about to fly again. Elbow drop right to the back. Right in that subscapularis area. Goodbye. It's all over for Mancini. Maybe for quite some time.
That man could be permanently injured. He could be out.
The winner of this bout, the one-man gang.
One-man gang indeed. Mario Mancini not doing too much for the one-man gang to do, did he? Let's go back and take a look at some of the action as this match unfolded. Watch him just ram the kisser right into the canvas.
Told you
knocked
he was
him
sick.
Right into the middle of next
Told
week.
He was sick.
Then he polished it off with this elbow. Unreal. Always something of special interest going on in the WWF, so let's spread the word.
All right, hi again, everybody. Mean Gene Okerlund here, and my guest this week, a man that is known very well from Detroit, Michigan. Truly one of the great superstars in the World Wrestling Federation. George, the Animal Steel, come on in, if you will. So many things happening to you as of late here in the World Wrestling Federation. And I wanted to take the time to talk about some of the things that have been going on.
Elizabeth!
You like her, don't you?
And? What's his name?
What? Macho Man Randy Savage. That's it. You like Elizabeth, don't you, George?
Russell, Macho Man. Saturday night main event.
Good, George. That's exactly what it was. Well, George, try to explain.
Little Danny Davis.
He hit you on the side of the head. He blasted you with a 20-pound steel bell.
Look out! Davis!
That name rings a bell, doesn't it, George? Danny Davis. He's not up there. You can trust... George, you can trust me. If there's anybody in this world you can trust, it's me. pal.
Nice.
George, don't kill a good thing.
Davis!
Downski. Thanks, George.
Bye-bye.
Hey, Professor. I thought only students fell asleep in your class.
They're just trying to get these finals graded.
You ought to revive with Vivarin.
Oh, Vivarin.
Helps wake you up.
Government-appointed experts confirm Vivarin's safe and effective.
Revive with Vivarin.
Listen to the sound of a closer, smoother shave. Williams Electric Shave sets up my beer, so my shaver shaves closer, and I get a smoother shave. Listen to Williams Electric Shave. Mm. The sound of a closer, smoother shave.
If it breaks, I got a hold on you. Here's what you gotta do. Bring home all the action. You'll get more satisfaction when you bring home all the action. Get a grip. Get a lock. Get a hold on everyone. All the thrills, all the fun. Bring home all the action.
And now the WWF Superstar.
Bring home all the action.
From LJN.
You've seen hundreds of dealer ads telling you what you will find. Here's something you won't find at Turner Nissan. Dealer markup on any car or truck. No dealer markup over the factory window sticker price means Turner Nissan can save you thousands. And Turner Nissan Spring Inventory Clearance Sale makes a great deal even better. Choose from a large selection of 87 Sentras for only $94 a month. 87 hard bodies are just $109 a month. Why pay more? Get a real deal at Northern California's number one Nissan sales leader, Turner Nissan, Fulton Avenue.
What are you missing if you're not renting to own at Rent-A-Center? A great deal.
Get a free microwave when you rent to own any of these appliances from Rent-A-Center at a special price. Choose this Whirlpool refrigerator, or this full-size washer and dryer, or this Speed Queen portable washer and dryer. Rent any of these appliances and get a microwave absolutely free.
And if you're not happy, you get back your first week's rent. It's a great deal. Don't miss it. Call now. Rent-A-Center. Count on us for a great deal.
Brian Heenan, you want to know why you're in so much trouble. We're going to take you back now to several weeks ago when this particular match went down between the Olympian Ken Patera and Hercules Hernandez and all the extracurricular things that you inspired.
Me?
Yes.
I don't think so. You can bet those two you just saw a moment ago are really concerned. More than concerned. It's coming in the ring. The king is coming in the ring. And then you get a block of the head.
Well, now we know why Harley Race was here, don't we?
I guess so. It shows that Bobby Eaton has no faith in Hercules. And perhaps very little in the king as it relates to skills of Ken Patera.
What this shows, you hurt Bobby Heenan, you're going to pay for it.
What are you on my case for? I didn't do nothing.
Well, who was out there? You were out there. The king was out there to surprise me. Surprise the rest of your family wasn't
there. Don't bother somebody else.
This bout is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Hollywood, California, weighing 270 pounds, Tim Patterson. The opponent, from Portland, Oregon, weighing 265 pounds, the former Olympian, Ken Patera.
Oh, look at this, Brian, a standing ovation here. Even you're standing, I can't believe it. For the former Olympian, Ken Patera. They're on their feet as one here, showing the respect to this man. Since making his way back here to the World Wrestling Fest, he's pointing at you, Brian. Right at you. Take a look at it. Here he is, right here. Where are you going? Sit down here. Sit down here. You're
don't
not
touch
going
me. I'm got a bad neck. Who knows what that moron's going to do?
Oh, all right, Kenny.
Jump out of the ring and come and get me.
Don't fall off this platform here. Just sit down and behave yourself. Now where are you going? Put your headset on. You're not going anywhere. Sit down here.
Look at him. He's obsessed.
Wow. He is obsessed, and he rightly so. Why shouldn't he be?
Well, he didn't do enough to me.
You've obviously put the word out to your entire stable family. I'm sorry. to really do a number on Ken Patera any way, shape, or form they can.
I'll give you a little secret. I'll tell you in a minute.
And you can bet that Ken Patera will respond to that with everything he's got in his arsenals. It's a vendetta now.
One by one, the Weasel family is going to fall. That's right, Hercules, if I have to go through you first, all the way through King Harley Race, King Kong Bundy, all the way to the giant himself, just to get to you, Hayden, that's what it's going to take, that's what I'm going to do.
Former Olympian Ken Patera.
The man's got an opponent in the ring. He should concern himself with that man, not me. Has he done enough damage to me?
It's a vendetta now.
Okay, if that's the way he wants it, fine. I've got the brains, I've got the money, and I've got the people on my side. Patera, you can't hear me now, but pal, it is over for you.
How many people do you think will be lining up on the side of Ken Patera?
None.
Yeah. You would be surprised.
Look at him. I'm getting out of here.
I heard he said you look ridiculous.
I'm getting out of here.
You resemble that remark.
I certainly do.
Yeah.
No, I don't.
Backing him up into the corner, Patera, obviously not worried too much about Tim Patterson. Patterson unloading with a couple of elbows. Benny's been a long time since he's been inside that squared circle, but still he's got that power.
Look at the eyes. Look at the eyes on that man. That man's dangerous.
Yeah, you can attest to that.
He's a violent animal.
Got this capacity crowd 100% behind him in everything he's done so far.
What is this, right in cell block 11? This is wrestling.
Patera, the powerhouse. Former Olympian. Medal winner. Look at that big suplex.
Uh-oh. He's not right.
You think you've got power in your stable with Hernandez?
What's he going to do here?
Oh, look at that. Jerk slam. Threw him halfway across the ring. Patera going to work.
Look at this. Look at this. Look at this monster.
Bear hug. The patented bear hug of Ken Patera.
Look at that.
Really put it on him. Squeezing for all his worth. The youngster didn't waste any time giving up.
Look at the face of the guy.
He's pointing right at you.
The face on the guy
pointing right at you.
What's wrong with this guy?
He's not done with you by a long shot.
I want some protection out here, and I want it now. Look at that man. There's something wrong with him.
Ken Patera leading the cheer of Weasel here. He's got your number, I'm afraid. Your neck bothering you? It should be bothering you.
The winner of this bout, Ken Patera.
Ken Patera, a very impressive victory, showing us that tremendous physique that he still possesses and that awesome power that only Ken Patera could put together. Your neck bothering you? Well, we'll get you some help. Right now, a special word on upcoming WWF events.
All right, the longtime ladies champion, the Fabulous Moolah, welcome back to Sacramento Arco Arena. Next Sunday night, June the 7th, you've got a title defense. Challenger, Miss Debbie Combs.
Thank God. I'm glad she was finally had guts enough to challenge me because I accepted it before she did. I've been waiting for this for a long, long time. And I've got a lot in store for Miss Debbie, and I'm sure she'll never forget the Fabulous Moolah if she's able to walk out of that ring.
She's got some lovely hair. I like
her. Well, that's up to you. So it won't be that lovely when I turn her loose because I've got a lot of swinging to do by that hair, and it's a lot of hair to swing, so... I'm really looking forward to this match.
I like to swing a little myself.
Well, that's up to you and Debbie, not up to me.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Longtime ladies champion, the Fabulous Moolah. Arco Arena next Sunday night, June the 7th. Danny Davis, come on in. Phenomenal card, Ricky Steamboat. Of course, it's going to be challenged by Hercules. And you're going to be going against Billy Jack. Your man is going against Billy Jack. How would you sign a match like that, Jimmy Hart?
Because we've got an open contract. And this man runs from nobody, right, baby?
Got to be nuts.
This is why
it's too much too soon.
When Jimmy Hart offered me a position in the Hart Foundation, I accepted. This man is the brains behind the brawn. He knows that Billy Jack Haynes is at his weakest point right now, and it's to my advantage to challenge him in June.
June 7th. How can you say that?
And defeat him. Can you imagine the prestige and the notoriety I'll get when I beat Billy Jack Haynes?
Yeah, listen, if you beat him, you bet. That's going to be a big move upward for you.
Well, that's why Jimmy Hart's my manager. And I was the greatest referee there ever was. And I know all the rules, and I'm going to use them too. All right. Between the two of us, we can't lose.
I don't know. It might be too much too soon, Jimmy Hart.
He's ready. You may have overdone
it this time. Stay tuned. We're going to be right back after this.
Take good care of your car, but forget your brakes. Might as well do this. Keep it running like a top, but neglect your brakes? Might as well get it over with now. Bendix brakes pass tougher tests than any law requires, so think about Bendix. But ignore your brakes? Okay. Bendix brakes. The sooner, the better.
Brill Cream always gave a man what he wanted. And we still do. Brill Cream Mousse, for that soft, natural feel and control that lasts all day. Brill Cream gives a man what he wants.
Fancy perfumey aftershave. It's got to be a quarterback's locker.
Real guys who get mud on their uniforms use rugged, honest stuff. Ice Blue Aqua Velva.
There's something about today's Aqua Velva man.
So you still think linemen are dumb?
Full line of Volkswagen Jettas. German engineered, fuel injected engine. Front wheel drive. And now the best deal yet. 3.9 financing plus factory incentives on all Jetta models. But hurry, this limited offer makes them go fast.
Hey, Butch, I want to teach everyone a new word. Chiquito, see? Chiquito.
Well, yeah, it is more important to tell people what they are. Chiquito's a shredded chicken rolled in a corn tortilla topped with salsa and sour cream topping.
I knew that.
But, Eddie, I'll bet you didn't know that right now at Pioneer Chicken, you can get three freshly made Chiquitos, spicy rice, and delicious refried beans for only $2.29.
Mmm, Chiquitos. What a great idea,
sure,
eh?
Butch. Sure. Sure, Butch. Sure. Whatever you say, Butch.
Well, last week, folks, we showed you some footage of superstar Billy Graham when he was the World Wrestling Federation reigning heavyweight champion and some of the things that went down in his career and the ultimate injury that ended up in the operation that we're going to see right now. If you're a little squeamish, don't watch this one.
Continuing our special report on superstar Billy Graham, the former World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champ faced massive hip surgery and what his doctor called the end of his wrestling career. With a new metal hip, Graham would be fortunate just to walk like a healthy man again. Wrestling, simply out of the question. We talked with the superstar just prior to his operation, and it seemed like we were talking about two different cases.
Superstar Billy Graham right here, just ready, hours, minutes away from the operation. The doctor said you'll never wrestle again. The critics said the greatest surgeon in the world says you'll walk. But superstar, your wrestling career is over. But I'm here to tell you, doctors, I'm here to tell the critics, I'll wear the tie-dyed t-shirts, I'll wear the tie-dyed wristbands again, superstar Billy Graham, I'll put the boots on again, I've been slain, I've been cut down, but no man, no surgeon, nobody can keep the superstar down. I'm coming back.
There's a good reason as to why doctors said Graham should never wrestle again. We'll show you that now. It's part of his hip surgery. And I do want to warn you, this footage is graphic and visually explicit, and some of you may want to turn your heads. But while skeptics and doctors were talking retirement, superstar preferred another word, comeback. And as amazing as it may seem, Billy Graham is not kidding around. The recovery is underway. And I met Graham recently on his training grounds in the mountains of Arizona.
You have done it all, certainly in the World Wrestling Federation, a champion for 4 years. What can be gained? Need a hand.
Oh, no, don't touch me. I'm going to make it. I don't care if I got to crawl. I don't care if I fall. I'm going to get to the top of this mountain, and I'm not going to have any help from anybody. I'm going to conquer it.
As determined as ever, fighting logic and nature, perhaps, the superstar's recovery is moving along.
Oh. Oh.
Superstar, take it easy. Don't hurt yourself.
Don't worry about it. I'm going to do it. I can do it. I know I can do it. Two or three more at once. Ow! Ow!
Next week, the latest on the incredible comeback effort of the superstar, Billy Graham.
Indeed, that was some awesome footage of the operation of superstar Billy Graham. Highly unlikely that anyone could ever return to the ring after something like that. Demolition, one of the hottest teams right now here in the World Wrestling Federation, now under the tutelage of the Devious One, Mr. Fuji. And these two powerhouses, once they step inside that squared circle, can do just about anything they would like to.
Oh, look at them. They're terrifying.
I'm surprised you didn't come up with some of your own bread and purchase the
contract. Let me tell you something. I not only have aligned my whole family, but I've also talked to a very big...
Well, what is it? Spit it out.
Well, my neck's hurting me. I've got probably the biggest group of professional wrestlers right now that I'm going to pay money to make sure Patera is done.
Is that a fact?
No, that's a promise.
That's a promise. I'm sure that Kenny Patera is well aware of the devious things that you can do, Bobby the Brain Heenan, and what some of your family members can do. Oh, look at that kisser. Halloween all over again. Demolition, the powerhouse team indeed, but they're going to find all the competition they want right here in the World Wrestling Federation, and they're not ducking it.
It's kind of like this. When Fuji gets a little smile on his face, ass breaks an ankle, and then I break a neck. Isn't that right? It's one by one. Whoever's in our way is going to be demolished. That's what Fuji wants.
Demolition vowing to demolish everything in their path, and they might just be able to do that.
Seems like Fuji gets sicker and sicker as the weeks go by.
That paint may be seeping into his brain that he's using on his face.
Fuji's sadistic, all right.
He certainly is.
Good friend of mine.
Yeah, those are the kind of friends, the only kind of friends you have. Look at the awesome power of Axe. As he's really doing the number now.
Drove
him down into the canvas. Not just any plain old slam, but just try to plant him.
Look at those boots. Those boots got to weigh 50 pounds.
Look at Fuji, not happy that the youngster's out on the floor. He wants him out there and creating more havoc. Smash in there now. I believe that smash is in there now, Brian, is it not?
Or X.
Oh, yeah, that's what I figured. I just about to get that down. Oh, clothesline him right on the top rope. That could be deemed a disqualification if the referee saw fit.
I think it was an accident.
It is indeed a smash inside. Doing a number of his own. Irish whip and put his head down. That surprised me because this is a very ring-weary, shall we say, team. Veterans.
Nothing. You're not hurting him. You're not denting him, punk.
The youngster, Bill Anderson, just ran into a brick wall.
Foggy broke the turnbuckle. These may be some men that are going to do me a favor.
Do your favor. You'll have to spread a lot of them around. Look at that. Just threw him over like a rag doll. Fuji screaming instructions.
Watch this.
Second turnbuckle on the inside. Axe perched up there. Wide open. Flying elbow. Just about decapitate him. Good night. Get the hot shower ready for that youngster.
Nobody's going to beat these guys.
Here are your winners. Demolition.
Demolition. Very impressive here this week. They're not satisfied with beating one guy. They're going to try to maim the other one. Let's go back and take a look at the double duty here as he's set up in his backbreaker position. Can't move and halt. Did he nail him? He certainly did nail him. Right now, we're going to go to our special Greg DeGeorge with Brutus Beefcake on comments from last week's match with Dino Bravo.
All right, with the barber, Brutus Beefcake, and of course the problems continue with
the Dream Team and yourself, they've been going on and on.
You know, Greg the Hammer, I knew what you were like all along. You and Dino Bravo with Johnny V, the new Dream Team. Well, I'm going to turn your new Dream Team into a nightmare. You know, when I get my hands on you, I'm going to start cutting right away. You know, you could use a little trim yourself.
Yeah.
I gotta take a break. I wanna play in the rain and take a break. 7 up so cool and clear. Yeah, it feels as good as the rain down here.
Gotta take a break.
7
up. I wanna play in the rain and take a break.
It's a good coming down.
Now you can win a year's worth of free travel on United Airlines. Plus $25,000. Look for the 7 up play all day game.
7 up.
Skittles, what's a Skittles?
Oh, so
smooth, splurging,
snappy light,
sassy, saving,
super orange,
sneaking,
spunky lemon,
yeah,
colorful candy shells, fruit flavors in the middle,
single-handed, bite-sized, candy-coated Skittles,
scrumptious,
sharing, smile,
sweet strawberry,
sorry, yeah,
taste the rainbow muffin flavors in Skittles.
Don't have Pepsi?
You know it don't come easy.
No Coke, huh?
It don't come easy.
Could I get more ice, please?
When getting a little thing like a soft drink starts getting hard...
You call this a large?
Come to 7-Eleven, where you'll always get your favorite soft drink fixed by someone who knows just how you like it. You.
Now that's what I call a large.
Today's 7-Eleven, where the good things come easy.
Listen. It's only a great America.
Save $3 on each general admission with coupons from participating Jack in the Box restaurants.
Last week we saw some footage of Killer Khan, the latest discovery of Mr. Fuji, and some of the most unusual and unique things he can do. Well, here's some more.
Oh, you look at Killer Khan's face. You look his face. So ugly. Everybody afraid. In fact, in Japan, they see him nighttime. They run away. They said, Obake. He said, face like vampire, like devil, like a demon. He has face of fear. But I can be prepared.
Brain, this guy is unreal. We're going to have to put a leash on him.
Good looking guy.
This is a tag team bout scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, in the corner to my left, at a combined weight of 469 pounds, B. Brian Blair, Jumping Jim Brunzel, the Killer Bees. The opponents, at a combined weight of 480 pounds, from the Double Cross Ranch in Amarillo, Texas, Jimmy Jack Funk. And his tag team partner from parts unknown, The Raider
and Jimmy Jack stepping in against the Killer Bees here this week. What an interesting match that would make. Killer Bees against Demolition.
A bees would last about as long as a ice cream cone in the desert.
Are you referring to one of the World Wrestling Federation ice cream bars?
I've seen you woof down quite a few.
Gorillas like ice cream bars. Yeah, I'll have to agree
with
you.
What have they got on? Are those little bee tennies they wear?
Got some kind of new foot attire that the bees have just been using here these last few weeks. Look at this flying head scissors.
They got bee booties on.
Jumping Jim Brunzel, the master of the dropkick. The Lone Ranger in there right now, referring to JJ. Talk about guys not having both oars in the water. B. Brian with a little sting action, unloading now on the left arm and shoulder of Jimmy Jack Funk. Nice go behind there by JJ.
Oh, he can wrestle.
Quite an outstanding amateur background as well for being Brian Blair.
Oh, really?
Spends a lot of time.
He made it further than the third grade?
Please. Reaching back. Oh, right up over the top. Nice move by Brian. Right back into a nice deep sunk arm drag. There's the quick tag to Jumpin' Jim. Double slingshot. Nailed him.
These bees remind me of Patera.
In what respect?
Look at all the stripes.
Oh, please.
Only thing they're missing are some numbers.
We don't deal in stripes anymore for your information. Tag made. Leapfrog right into a small package right in the center of the ring. Referee right there, two count only. Raider made sure that that didn't go down.
These bees been doing a lot of teamwork. I mean, they've been working out together a lot. And as far as I'm concerned, I think they've wasted their time.
Tommy the Brain, I'm sure you're aware that the World Wrestling Federation magazine is a real hot item, and right now it's a monthly publication. In fact, you had your kisser in the last one.
That's why it sold so well.
Well, going to be photos, special photos in this new edition from WrestleMania 3 that's on the stands right now. In addition, the World Wrestling Federation August edition will have all the details of a Lunch with World's Heavyweight Champion Hulk Hogan contest. So keep your eyes peeled for the new WWF magazine.
Must be fun to win a lunch with Ken Patera. You both can eat off 10 plates.
Please. I know a lot of people that would give almost anything to have lunch with a Hulkster.
Really?
Yes.
You must know a lot of people with nothing to do.
Leapfrog. B. Brian really doing a number here right now on the Raider, who wants out of there.
This is all illegal.
The Raider reached back and tagged Jumpin' Jim Brunzell. Did you see that? Didn't even have a clue which section of the ring he was in.
These bees are so darn confusing.
Why don't you say they're fast?
Well, I've never seen them out. Trouble.
Please. They really know how to make tag team action work. Look at a little sting action here by B. Brian. Double right down on the...
He must be using a deodorant that makes his arms stay together, and I think he does that to keep his arms free to move.
Educated guess. You weren't making all those smart remarks when Ken Patera was out here. You were looking for higher ground.
That's because I think the bees, as much as they probably don't care, I still think they think twice about putting a hand on me. Patera, you're dealing with a convict. This guy, he could care less. He'd climb right over all these people to get up here to me. He's a dangerous man.
He is, as far as you're concerned. Nice underhook. Fireman's carry. There's that old amateur play coming in. Unloaded as Jimmy Jack obviously wasn't paying attention. He got clobbered. Now the tag, you notice how they cut the ring in half.
And they waited to make the tag in front of the referee.
Wow.
Like they, here referee, look, we would never do nothing wrong. We're the killer bees.
That.
I don't like him.
I'm sure the feeling is mutual. There's a little beasting action for you right there. First the leg, two count only. Jimmy Jack tried to come in and lower the boom, but he got caught right in the middle. Atomic drop right into the outstretched arms, and he got his bell rung there by Jumpin' Jim.
Uh-oh.
Drop down. There's that drop kick. The patented one by Jumpin' Jim Brunzell. Run the hot water.
I really believe nobody drop kicks better than that guy.
Nobody that I know of. You actually gave a compliment to the Killer Bees.
What do you think I am? Just bias?
The winners of this bout, the Killer Bees.
I don't have to like him, to be honest.
Killer Bees are very impressive here this week. Let's go back and take a look.
Okay, here they go. Now Brunzell's in. He's up for the drop kick. Look at that. He's got to be up 7 feet in the air. He goes for the cover. I believe he hooks the man's trunks here. I can't really tell.
Oh, come on.
Well, I'm just... You asked me to do it. I'm doing it. Oh, you're going to have another ice cream bar, aren't you?
Oh, there's another shot of the brand new WWF ice cream bar taking the nation and this youngster by storm. Where can I get one of those?
Good little boy. Got all over your face. Good manners.
We'll be right back.
One love. Get close-up.
Introducing Close-Up's refreshing new paste.
Get close-up. When you're close-up, that's when close-up comes.
fresh mouth. It's the nicest thing that you can do. Do it for me, and I'll do it for you. More love, get closer.
Now in paste and in gel.
Come on, it's a surprise.
Comfortable, roomy, a BMW?
Has more combined passenger and cargo room than BMW.
Great performance. A Nissan 200SX.
Has more standard horsepower than 200SX.
I give up.
Renault Medallion.
How did you learn so much about cars?
It's easy when you have both eyes open.
Now get 3.9 annual percentage rate financing or $300 cash back at your California Renault Jeep dealer.
Well, I'm still here at my America's Choice taste test booth, and there's a lot of you out there who haven't taken the test yet. Now, I know, you hate to take tests, your palms get sweaty, and you can't shake hands for a week, but this isn't that kind of test. You can't fail. All you have to do is choose which cola tastes better. Nothing could be simpler. And nobody fails, nobody loses. Well, almost nobody.
Let your taste decide, and discover once and for all why Pepsi is America's Choice.
This next bout is scheduled for one fall. It is a six-man tag team event. Introducing first the Doctor of Style, Slick. He represents, at a combined weight of 824 pounds, from Tehran, Iran, the Iron Sheik. From Kansas City, the Natural Butch Reed. And from the Soviet Union, Nikolai Volkov.
I hope he sings.
Oh, come on.
Hey, Buckethead!
Talking to you, Munson.
I'm talking about you, Jim Duggan.
Oh.
You know this man is supposed to sing the national anthem of Russia. So why come you not out here to try to stop it? What are you doing somewhere drinking a beer or taking it easy? Well, let me tell you something. He's been singing the national anthem, and he's going to keep on singing, and he's going to sing it right now. And I want all you goofy people to stand up and show some respect.
Give me a break. You can bet if Hacks on Jim Duggan was here, he wouldn't be doing this. What a disgusting display that was.
The opponents, at a combined weight of 776 pounds, from Tampa, Florida, Joe Myrtle. From Appleton, Minnesota, Brad Ringens. And their partner from Antigua in the West Indies, S.D. Jones.
Special delivery.
And you people shut up and don't say you are sir. You are sir.
Well, maybe they'll let him sing one time.
Brad, he can sing?
No, I'm talking about the Sheik. He always feels left out. That's why he had to grab the microphone there. Brad Ringens, former Olympian star.
Look at this.
Look at the block of the suplex. Oh, and there's one of his own, a beauty. Double trip takeover. You know, the Sheik and Nikolai Volkov and Slick and Butch Reed also almost so negative about the United States of America, we asked them if there was anything they liked about the U.S. of A.
You know, the milk is too sour and the honey too sweet. But, you know, I did find something about the USA that I like. And you know exactly what it is. It's a money.
Well, they got a lot of money.
Is that some of your money?
You never know.
I know you talked about spreading some around. I
Nice kick out by Brad. A tag made to Special Delivery Jones.
The Natural Butch Reed. Natural what?
Think that's natural blonde hair? Highly unlikely.
If he says it is, I'm not going to call the man a liar.
Well, I will.
Sure, you don't have any respect for people.
Nice leapfrog by SD. Side bear takeover. Oh, right into a pinning combination with a handful of tights there by the Natural. Actually, SD not in any trouble there of being pinned because he could just turn loose in a headlock at any time.
Now, who knows if he's smart enough?
The man from Antigua has a lot of gray matter, brain. Maybe more than you've got.
Are you kidding?
You got some black matter, because I can see that ring around the collar there that we talked about earlier.
Hey, keep your hands to yourself.
Don't you ever wash that thing?
Yes, I do. It's not white, though. It's the color of it.
It's not white. It's not white now, you mean. The Natural trying to get rid of Joe Murdo. Joe Murdo at about that 300-pound mark. He's a handful in there.
It's a big guy, Murdo.
Oh, look at that. The big Russian planted one right into the kidney area of Mr. Murdo. Right in that lower lumbar area of the vertebrae. Nikolai with a spinning mule kick. He's got quite a bit of agility for a 300-pounder.
It's known as a Cossack kick.
Cossack kick. Still going to work on that back area that's been injured already. What's the Sheik looking for? Rose line and a beauty by Nikolai. Look at this, the Natural perched up there, that second turnbuckle on the inside. Bombs away with another clothesline of his own. Tag made to the Sheik. Uh-oh, setting him up.
Camel clutch.
We're going to see
this. This is my all-time favorite. A man really suffers in this.
What does he have to adjust his mustache for before he applies this? Oh, he's got it on now. Those fingers are locked.
He's got it.
Sam Murdo won't be able to take this pain for very long. Come on, referee, before they do some serious back injury here. There's the bell.
Slick, you got a good team there.
Here's a special word on upcoming WWF events.
I know for a fact there are thousands and thousands of fans around the world that are paying attention to what this man is doing. Mr. Fuji, come on in. First of all, let's talk about your background. The samurai warrior, the master of the martial arts from Osaka, Japan. You've done it all as a professional wrestler, still continue to do so. And you've now become one of the premier wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation. And Mr. Fuji, if you think for a second that I have not been paying attention, Morocco and Orton are part of your army.
Oh, very, very true. Morocco is sick like Mr. Fuji. Orton is getting to the halfway house as a sick person. Good communication.
Also, demolition, axe and smash. Oh. What did you pull? Was that a coup?
Oh, axe and smash. Very good. Because they have mind-to-mind communication like Mr. Fuji, and they want to make people suffer. You see all that spike? Every day they go training, hitting to blood come out of each other's chest.
Oh, that's sick. That's sick.
Oh, thank you.
What about Killer Khan, this latest acquisition of yours? Where did you pick this guy up at?
Mongolia.
Mongolia.
Killer Khan is also a former sumo champion of Japan. Grand champion.
And I've heard
he is very good. Strong leg, strong body, strong mind, and ugly face.
Does he still wear the sumo outfit periodically?
Yes. I will have surprised the American people very soon on Khan-san.
All right. What about the rest of your entourage? Oh, they're starting to filter into our studio this week. Oh, my goodness, I can't believe
Let me tell you, I have tag team. A lot of tag teams. Three tag teams. Now I have Kamala and Sika and Kimchi. Remember this, Mean Gene. Mr. Fuji, not once, not twice, not three, but six time WWF Tag Team Champion.
I'm aware of that. Mr. Fuji, just for the benefit of some of those rare few in this great country, perhaps I could prevail upon you to speak a little Japanese when you talk about these men.
Let me tell you, I'll be very honored to speak Japanese. But now it's lunchtime. Japanese people all go out eat lunch. So nobody watching television. So sorry. So I must talk about Kamala and Sika. Kamala want to eat. Kamala, every time you talk about food, he's hungry. Sika, every time you talk about seafood, he gets more hungry for crab. But he loves seafood. And now, Kimchi, you tell him he will have food. You speak it.
Promise him that he'll have food, pal, please.
Please.
Sooner or later, we'll get him to a restaurant. Thank you very much, Mr. Fuji. Kimchi, Kamala Sika, thank you very much, really.
The new Mitsubishi Mighty Max, patiently crafted to be serious fun for the money. Only $64.99. Mighty Max gives you more standard features than Toyota, Nissan, or Mazda. And it's still priced lower than all three. And right now, special factory incentives could save you hundreds. The Mitsubishi Mighty Max. When you're ready for some serious fun for the money, it's ready to kick up a little dust. Mitsubishi.
This is my lava machine. And this is my lava machine. New lava liquid. In 30 years of working with my hands, I've never used a hand cleaner like it. Power of pumice in a liquid. Feel it. Powering away dirt, grease, just about anything. Powering hands clean. I'm Roger Gustin. Friend, when I talk power, I know what I'm talking about.
Lava, new liquid and traditional bar. Powers hands clean.
Hi. I just moved in next door. Could I borrow a Diet Pepsi?
Sure.
Yes.
Be right with you.
When you go all out for taste, the taste to go out for is Diet Pepsi.
You okay in there?
Here's your Diet Pepsi.
Thanks. I hope it wasn't too much trouble.
No trouble at all.
Diet Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
What are you missing if you're not renting to own at Rent-A-Center? A great deal.
Get a free microwave when you rent to own any of these appliances from Rent-A-Center at a special price. Choose this Whirlpool refrigerator, or this full-size washer and dryer, or this Speed Queen portable washer and dryer. Rent any of these appliances and get a microwave absolutely free.
And if you're not happy...
Wrestling Challenge, and we had some surprises, and Kenny Patera... had a finger pointing at you, Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Yeah, well, he better point that finger. It's be the last thing he's going
to
point.
Next week, we have plenty more exciting action coming your way as we're going to deal with the Honky Tonk Man.
And the Colonel.
Well, you can bet that the Colonel will be there as well.
My man, Hercules.
Hercules Hernandez, a powerhouse, maybe not as powerful as Patera. We'll have to wait and see. We're also going to take at this unique individual, a look at him, George the Animal Steel. Talk about Harry Beaver and the former Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, joining us as well next week. Plus a whole lot. Look at the dirt you've got there.
Hey, right you keep your
don't
hands
you ever
to
wash that? So long,
I haven't. You keep your hands to yourself. I got a bad neck.